her parents sent her out of the house this morning, and now she's not coming home tonight.
As students struggled tonight after learning one of their classmates was hit and killed by a bus after school. Good evening. Everyone at East High School is grieving after a freshman lost her life suddenly this afternoon. First News reporter Matt Horn explains how the tragic accident happened and starts off by telling us what will be different as the students report for class tomorrow.
There will be grief counselors here at East High School on Thursday after a tragic accident Wednesday afternoon took the life of a 14-year-old freshman.
The worst case scenario. Anytime we have a fatality, a student involving a bus driver involved in this, the worst case scenario.
As students were getting out of school for the day,
it was shocking. You don't really hear about stuff like that happening.
A Youngstown City school bus with students on board hit and killed a freshman student. Eyewitnesses tell police that students walking from East High School were playing around when the girl stumbled on the road in front of the bus.
You know, there's going to be a lot of people affected by it, so we'll have teams of people in place.
Family and friends at the accident were visibly distraught. One was even taken to the hospital from the scene. Youngstown City Schools is working closely with police and say they are doing what they can to help the family as well.
Be an intervention going on with the family too.
East High School junior Janice Williams had lunch at the same time with the student.
I look at this girl every day because she sits in the same place every day. And now tomorrow that place is just going to be empty. She's not going to be there.
Until the investigation is complete, we're told the driver will not be driving a school bus.
The next few days will be kind of a little test for us to make sure we get everybody taken care of.
The investigation is still ongoing. The school bus will be taken to an impound lot here in the city. In Youngstown, Matt Horn, WKBN 27 First News.